What is up, guys? It is August. Hey, what's the date today?
7.
August 7. And it's 9:36 in the nighttime.
In the nighttime? So fun.
So, in the nighttime, 9:36. And we are currently at the gym. I got my brother with me. Wave your finger. I just got off work at 9 o'clock. It's a long day today, busy day. But I wasn't even gonna come to the gym, but I was like, fuck it. Tomorrow's my day off, so I'll just go to the gym today and just do whatever I wanted tomorrow. So another thing off my list, so today is a pool day. Power pool day? When I say power, it will be like 8 to 10 reps.
8 to 12.
Yeah, 8 to 12. Yeah, 8 to 12 reps. That's my power for back, because I don't really want to go heavy and snap my shit up. So right now I'll be taking my pre-workout. I forgot my shaker at home. One more sports. So watch me take it. If you guys don't have a shaker or can't afford one like me, you just gotta take it to the freaking dome. So right here, one full scoop, as you can see. Just gonna put this in my mouth. That's what she said. That was pretty shitty. I don't really like doing this, but it's convenient. I don't have to wash my shaker cup at home. Here, this last one already.
You eat them.
I ate this taro mochi right here, right before I came. Kulolo. If you don't know, it's a Hawaiian dessert. Basically mixed with taro and milk. Sorry if the music's too loud. Mixed with taro and milk and like a flour or something. It's like a mochi. So yeah, I'm just gonna eat this. Weight update. I don't know how much I weigh at the moment. The last time I checked myself, I fluctuated up 183. I did weigh myself this morning because I was almost late to work, so I had to get my priorities done first, prep all my meals before work, and yep. Another thing to cover up. Oh yeah, if you guys notice my channel art, it is creative, but it's not that all that, but I just need something to show, but it's pretty dope. Shout out to my bro Oji for making it. It's a quick design. I just told him something simple and it throws out the meaning of my channel. And stay tight. That's pretty much it. So shout out to Oji. He is also a vlogger. I mean, not a vlogger, but he's a YouTuber. He just started like a month ago or 2 months ago before I started. I think his YouTube name is BraddahOji. I'll drop his YouTube channel on the bottom. So he was that blogger, like, you know. So all his, what his channel is about is I think he's playing Overwatch right now, so he does like commentary on his gaming and stuff. It's pretty cool. So and he's a freaking pro. So I played with him League of Legends a while back. I think season 6. I played with him, and damn, he knows his shit. And I learned how to play that game in like a month, until my computer started acting up. So I stopped playing it. So yeah, it's pretty cool. He's one of my cool friends. I'm pretty close with a pretty close friend of mine. So yeah, just if you are a gamer and you play Overwatch or League of Legends, follow him. His channel's for you. Yeah, that's about it, guys. I'll see you guys inside when I do my mobility work. Peace. That's about it for my rumble rover and stash stretching. Again, these stretchers are for basically my whole body really, but then I was mostly targeting my back and my knees, my patella tendonitis. It feels a little bit, it always feels better when I stretch, so I always do it 3 times a day. And I will, sometime in my next videos, I will do a video on how to deal with patella tendonitis. I have been having it for a long time now. I see like for over half a year, and I just have to deal with it. And for my leg days, all I do is mostly sumos now. I stopped squatting. I miss it, but it's not worth hurting myself, you know? So I always, I always do the seated leg press, just cause it doesn't put that much tension in my knees. I mean, it doesn't put any strain on my knees that much. So does sumo deadlift, so I will keep on doing that so I can strengthen my lower back.
strengthen my lower back. And strengthen my knees also. Strengthen that tendon. And right now I'm just rolling on my biceps because it is a pool day. I don't want to be catching cramps or having my my bicep tendon flaring up. Because once it flares up, then it's going to ruin my whole pool workout. So, yeah. I guess I'll see you guys at the first exercise. Alright guys, we're on our third set. Third set for the lat pull down we have here. We are hitting four sets of 8 to 10 or 8 to 12 reps. So the key for this movement, again, I think I seen you in that video, you just drive with your elbows. Drive your elbows into your back and you're gonna feel it all over all this part of your body.
It even helps too if you arch your back a little bit, so you're not doing this straight. If you arch your back like this, then you're gonna feel it more. Drive your elbows down straight. You wanna keep the muscle contraction, you don't wanna go all the way up like this. You just wanna keep it down like this. Steady, nice and slow. Chase the pump.
What is up guys? Now we are moving back on to cable rows. So the key to this one is to just pull to your belly button. Pull to your belly button and arch your back. I keep doing some champ. So you're gonna feel it all in your lower, not lower, but a little on the bottom of this part. And I told him to do a little bit more, but he couldn't. So I guess I gotta show you guys.
Straight, and a small arch. And you wanna pull it towards your elbows. Bring the cable to your belly button. So you're just doing this. And you really wanna focus on keeping the muscle contraction.
Muscle contraction.
With your elbows.
With your elbows.
Alright, so my brother wanted me to just act like I was a noob in the gym, and so he's gonna show me how to do this cable pull, rope pullovers. So I'm gonna act like I don't know anything. Okay, so show me how to do it now.
So, what you gotta
it's
do?
My first time working out.
You gotta bend down. Make your body straight. Your body straight.
This?
Then pull till you reach your elbow to like a 90 degree angle. Yeah, pull to your stomach.
That's good?
Yeah.
Am I supposed to feel it?
You're supposed to feel it around here.
No.
Your lower right here.
Yeah, that's
right
where here. I feel it. Yeah.
Alright, so I taught him well. That's actually the right way to do it. I was going like 2. As you can see, this was 27.5 pounds. Yeah, 27. And that was pretty good. That was a perfect weight. I told him don't lift heavy at these kind of movements. Just wasting a lot of energy trying to do it. And you're not gonna really feel the muscle connection. Alright guys, next workout, we are on the rear delt fly sort of key. So to start up this workout, this movement, you wanna have your arms, your arms at least parallel or above parallel with the bar, so you're gonna be targeting your rear delt, this part, and as you can see, chuggle. And you want to put your body pressed against the seat over here. And you want to keep your arms a little bit bent. We're doing it so you feel it more. Yeah, there you go. Then the only way to do this exercise really properly is to go really light, because the rear delts is a hard muscle to target. So
yeah, for all you people, don't do it like that. Do it my way. Just really wanna keep your arms straight. Just relax. Just curl. Keep your elbows
for the girls.
You don't wanna do this. You don't want to swing or jerk. You want to be doing that shit?
Okay.
You just want to be, keep your elbows planted into your stuff, into your stomach. And don't move that at all. That's pretty much a wrap, guys. So basically, all we did was, how much workouts we did? Oh yeah, sorry if I didn't film what was after bicep curls? I apologize, I didn't film.
Calf raises.
We also did calf raises. Calf raises and forearm curls. I didn't film it because I figure it's a really boring exercise, and again the video is gonna be too long. So yeah, that's pretty much a wrap. It was a pretty good workout, kinda boring actually. Pump chasing. No challenge was being set today. And this is pretty much the only time I come to the gym is only nighttime. If I have a cold day, I don't really come to the gym at nighttime when I have a push day or a leg day, because my body usually feels like super tired at night if I have like a push or a leg versus a push or a leg workout. I have to use like more energy and stuff. I'm sorry if I'm not explaining things right and you guys don't even understand me. I'm still new to this YouTube thing, and you know, things will get better, right, eventually. So right now I'm just warming up my knees. I'm gonna go a little bit faster, maybe 2.5. I usually stay on the treadmill for like at least 15 to 20 minutes. I don't really stay on that long, because when I'm at work, I'm basically on my feet the whole day as well. So I'm just wanting to warm up my knees and just get a little sweat in. And that's about it. I just focus. I just focus on my diet more than doing like a lot of tons of cardio. And also focusing more on my training as well. So my brother here. Are you done already? Look, the treadmill running itself. No calories burned. So stupid. He always plays around. It cracks me up a lot. But yeah, I guess tomorrow I will be filming a full day of eating because I'm off. So I have a lot of time to record my meals, and again, I'll do the same thing like I did last time. I will drop the macros on the bottom of the video. So yep, that's about it, guys. Thanks for watching. Like, share, and subscribe. Stay tight, fam.